I'm wearing camo. Y'all hashtag this. This party's raging. You won't want to miss. All my buddies turning up. Parking lot is full of trucks. Hang on tight, hang on tight. Oh, my, my, my. And I say, hey.
Bye. Step back. Back on your right. I'm going to stay up front.
Jeans are flooding through the door.
Thank you. Everybody's somebody. Kick, step, step, step. Move over a little bit. Move over just a bit. Yeah. Shuffle. Toe heel. Toe heel, right foot.
Thank you.
All right, I don't know where Jen is. I don't see nothing. Release me. We got time. Right together, forward. Release me.
To start the show in about 10 minutes. So work your way to your seats, and we're going to feature a little bit more country music. We're going to feature Stephen Olsen playing the dobro on a little tune called Panhandle Rag, dedicated to the panhandle of Alaska. We're going to start the show in 5 minutes, so I encourage every one of you to take your way and make your way to your seats. You don't want to miss the start of the show. We're starting in another 5 minutes, so I encourage everybody, get your drinks and off to your seats. We're going to go for a ride. right, take your seats, folks, and listen to Anna play the violin. Woo!
Starting the show in 5 minutes.
our own Railway Acuff, Mayor Mike Savage. Woo!
Welcome to a night in Nashville. Compliments of the Mental Health Foundation of Nova Scotia. I'm the new sheriff in town, Mayor Mike Savage, and I'm pleased as a possum to be your MC again this year. Y'all are in for a rootin' tootin', honky-tonkin', toe-tappin' kind of night. Let's hear it one more time for Debbie Arnold and her talented crew of line dancers. What a great way to kick off the show. All right, we have a positively stellar night for you, including Team Pat featuring Makayla Lynn. Have some of you heard of Makayla Lynn, eh? We got Minnie Pearl on steroids. We got the Country Divas, the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour, and Dolly Parton, speaking of steroids. Our hashtag tonight is DSOM2017. Okay, I want to make sure you're tweeting and Instagramming and post-it noting and everything else. So DSOM 2017. Please tweet, Facebook, Instagram, and share it through your social media channels. I'm just going to give you 5 seconds to get your devices out and tweet something, okay? Including, you can tweet at Mike Savage HFX. That's me. This is about raising awareness. Now let's hear it for our musical director, Lil Stevie, and the swinging buckaroos over here. Can't beat Stevie, I gotta tell you. You talk about a versatile performer, and what a crew he's with tonight. Stevie, how you doing?
Good, good. Most people just say I'm full of it.
Ah, yes, indeed. I might have said that too. What a great, we're gonna be fun tonight, eh? Don't you think?
Oh, tons of fun, tons of fun.
You've been doing a bit of work on this?
You're gonna love it. Everybody's gonna love it,
right?
Oh,
yeah, it's gonna be fun. We got some great stuff lined up tonight. We're also serving up fantastic prize tonight. Our wine and dine raffle is sure to impress. It includes dinner for eight in your own home, prepared by a chef from the Berkeley, with wine pairings from Bishop's Cellar, valued at well over $1,000. Tickets are only $20 each. Is there anybody here that hasn't got money with them? Great. All right, you had your chance. Thank you to our foundation friends, Catherine Campbell and Wayne Coyle, for providing this very generous prize tonight. Thank you, folks. Now, beyond having a great time here tonight, we're also making a difference in the lives of thousands of Nova Scotians. The numbers, they speak for themselves, guys. More than 200,000 people in our province are currently struggling with mental illness. Think about that, 200,000 people in a province of less than a million. Tonight, you have a chance to tilt the numbers in their favor by making a donation and supporting one of our stars. So, we're gonna start off the evening. They've been working hard on this, okay, these folks? They've been raising money, it's unbelievable. I want you to take a look at the current fundraising standings. Badoo! Look at that. Whoa, that's impressive. Look at that. Minnie Pearl, almost $50,000. Somebody here wants to be the one to get her over $50,000. The Country Divas, $27,550. The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour, $100,126. We got some folks in the room tonight who can put them over 200,000 very quickly, and I'm going to point you out later. How about Dolly Parton at 29,166? I want you to know that you can support your favorite performer at any point throughout the night by seeing one of our volunteers or by visiting the finance table. Where is the finance table? Where is it? Over here. The finance table. Oh, they're waving over there. Hey, folks. Thanks for your help. Good job tonight. Our team will one team will take home the coveted top fundraiser award, won last year by Matt Bergar as Bob Dylan. That was a great show. And another will capture the People's Choice Award, won last year by Tracy Kitch and Jennifer Gillivan as the Adeles, Jimmy Fallon, and the Roots. I don't know, are they here tonight? Is Tracy and Jennifer here? Well, if they're here, that was a show. Now, before we welcome our first act to the stage, I'd like to invite Mark Smith, the Vice President of Commercial Banking for Nova Scotia at BMO Bank of Montreal, to come up and say a few words. Once again this year, we're so thrilled to have BMO back as our presenting sponsor. Mark, come on up.
Thank you, Sheriff Savage. It's fantastic to be here tonight at a different stage of mine. All of us at BMO Bank of Montreal look forward to the signature event every year. We are incredibly proud of our partnership with the Mental Health Foundation of Nova Scotia and the work it does to change the way people think. As BMO celebrates its 200th year of banking in Canada, we are pleased to share the spotlight with tonight's stars. Good luck to all of them as they step outside their comfort zones to impact true change. We thank each and every one of them for having the courage and sense of humor to do so. Thanks as well to all of you. By being here tonight, you are demonstrating your support for Nova Scotians who are living with mental illness and addictions and their families. At BMO Bank of Montreal, we are here to help, and we're happy to know you are too. Hats off to the 14th annual Different Stage of Mind. Sit back, enjoy the show, cheer loudly, and give generously, y'all.
All right, thank you very much, Mark. We certainly appreciate the great support of BMO Bank of Montreal. Now, before we get into the official competition, we got a really special act tonight. And I've seen these folks, you're going to enjoy this a lot. We're going to kick off the night in Nashville. Don MacLachlan and her son, Adam Fleiger, have teamed up with Nova Scotia's own rising country star, Makayla Lynn, to treat us to an entertaining and poignant performance in honor of somebody very special. Don and Adam are members of Team Pat. And as you're, yeah. All right. Is there anybody here from Team Pat tonight? They're members of Team Pat, and as you're about to hear, they have a very powerful reason for joining us on stage tonight.
Team Pat generated a few Christmases ago, 4 or 5 years ago now, when my dad was feeling pretty down. And my girlfriend Ashley came together with a gift to give him, which was a t-shirt. And she had the matching t-shirt that said Team Pat. And that's where the first shirts kind of came from.
People who are in the moment of feeling unwell, it's very difficult for them to speak. He passed away in August 2015. Had everything, great family, circle of friends that loved him, and still the illness took him over.
You know, with more awareness, I think people will be more adapt to, you know, seeking out help.
Support is so important. You know, it really, like, imagine, I just think, how would somebody go through this alone?
So this is March 24th, and this is the day of my dad's birth. It's his birthday. And we'd just like everyone to take part in the celebration. And I think it, you know, this is a great opportunity to get on stage. You would have jumped at this opportunity, so yeah, the performance will be good.
And we want to celebrate his lovely spirit.
Yeah.
Hey. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Team Pat and Makayla Lynn.
So drive them old trucks, make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys, 'cause they'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds or gold. Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's. Each night begins a new day. If you don't understand him and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away. Your babies grow up to be cowboys. Woo! Don't let them pick guitars or drive them old trucks. Make them be doctors and lawyers and sons. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys, 'cause they'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone. You know, I'm so lucky to have my mama to be there for me in those rough times.
Well, we all know how important family is, and I'd just like to point out our friends, a special family called Team Pat. I know you're out there somewhere.
Yeah, but Mom, don't you think this whole group of us right now is just a big family shining light on mental health right now?
We're very happy to introduce Makayla Lynn. Talking about family, she's going to sing a beautiful song that she wrote for her mama. One, two, three.
worst of times. In my deepest doubt, you'd pick me up and push me higher than the clouds. In my weakest moments, in my greatest fears, you'd always be there to whisper in my ear. Not everything in life is gonna be easy. Not everything will go the way you stay strong, hold on, trust me. 'Cause at times when you don't think you can, I'll be there. When I feel like crying, when I fall to think I can, you'll be there, yeah. Oh, you'll be there. And think you just don't want to pay the price for everything you do, but I think I've got some good advice next time. Gonna be easy. Not everything will go the way you planned. You gotta stay strong, hold on, trust me. 'Cause at times when you don't think you
folks, is that a way to kick it off? And what a great story to be here tonight on the anniversary of the father's birth. It's a great testament to him. And we know Pat would be so proud of the two of you. What an incredible birthday gift for Pat. And now, Adam, does he look like a cowboy? Do you think? I can't tell you how many people have told me he's the second best looking cowboy here tonight. All All right, let's talk about Makayla Lynn. It's easy to see why you're spending so much time these days recording in Nashville, Tennessee. Good luck with the release of your new album, On a Dare and a Prayer. And thank you for continuing to be a strong youth voice for the Mental Health Foundation of Nova Scotia. And I want to tell you, too, that when Don and Adam agreed to perform here tonight, they didn't have to, but they asked to be able to fundraise in Pat's name. And we're so pleased to tell you that Team Pat has raised over $17,000 for A Different Stage of Mind. Way to go, Team Pat. Now listen, there's also still time to help this mother-son duo raise even more. Just see one of our volunteers or go to our finance table to add to Team Pat's total, which we'll announce at the end of the evening. And now it's time to start the official competition, and boy, do we have a mighty Minnie on deck. She's absolutely no stranger. Now listen, if you want to say something about her, her Twitter handle is @DartmouthG. And I'm sure that she's no stranger to y'all. The ever-charming, young, and talented Gloria McCluskey is strutting her stuff tonight in the name of mental health. And her persona of choice is Ms. Minnie Pearl. Now, some of y'all are too young. Like, you know, people like Robert Zed would be too young to understand all this. You know, Minnie Pearl was an American country comedian who appeared in the Grand Ole Opry for more than 50 years, the same length of time that Gloria was on city council. And she was on the TV show Hee-Haw from 1969 to 1991. So I also want to tell you that our video partners, Mark, John, and the team at RPM Productions recently spent some time with the unofficial Queen of Dartmouth and asked her about her reasons for wanting to help change the way people think. Ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your hats. You're in for a treat. Giddy-up go!
I'm here, ready to go on stage and maybe make a fool of myself. Every one of us deserves to live a good life. And because we're struck with a mental health illness, doesn't mean that we're a second-class citizen. I think people now realize that it is an illness like any other illness. I think the next steps for everyone is to even become more aware of how easy somebody can fall into a mental health issue. It doesn't take much, and I hope to see a world where children understand what other people live with and reach out to help rather than bully or say mean things. And I think if we work hard enough, that will come.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Minnie Pearl.
Howdy! Thank you. I'm just so happy to be here tonight. I came all the way from Grinder Switch, better known as Darwin. And I'm so happy to be here. But Mikey, what are you doing here? I thought I was going to be up here with that good-looking Joel Plaskett. And while you say you're the best-looking cowboy, you ain't no Joel Plaskett.
No, that's true.
I know you can't sing.
True that.
But get over here and
you're sure? All right, let me take a picture of you first here now. Okay.
Don't come too close.
Oh, yeah?
The last time I let a man get that close to me, he latched onto my lips, and I couldn't get clear.
I understand that.
Who was that?
Who was that now?
That was that good-looking Kim Conrad.
Oh! He excites me a little bit too, Gloria.
By the time I got clear, my knees were knocking like a woodpecker in a lumberyard.
I understand that.
Mikey, I bet you don't think anything happens to me anymore.
No, I believe anything.
But let me tell you, it does.
I believe that too.
It does. The other day, I went over to do a little bit of banking, and I bent down to tie my shoe, and I got caught in that revolving door.
Uh-oh.
And there I was, in there with a man, never been introduced, going around together.
Oh.
And we went around 300 times. And I was scared. But he never laid a hand on me. And although it was hard for him.
I bet.
Thank you, thank you.
I tried to catch you in there, but I couldn't catch up to you. I got stuck.
You know, Mikey, when we look out there tonight, there's some of them good-looking developers out there.
I see some of them.
Ones that used to give us the money.
I can see the $1,000 bills from here there, Dartmouth G. I see a couple over here.
And you know, Mikey, when I came in tonight, there were a couple of good-looking guys standing at the door.
That was me.
And I smiled at them, but they laughed out loud. And one of them said, "That's that Minnie Pearl. She likes to pretend she's from the country. I bet she doesn't know a goose from a gander." And I turned around and I said, "In Grinder Switch, we just throw them in Sullivan's pond and let them figure it out for themselves." And we ain't had no problem.
We do things right over there.
We do. But you know, Mikey, the other day after I got caught in that revolving door, I decided I'd stay all night. So I went down the road to the hotel. And there was a real sassy room clerk in there. And that's because that good-looking Rob Steele was hanging around there.
Uh-oh.
And they thought he was there just waiting for me. I wish he were, but he weren't. Anyway, I didn't know what to say. Me being so modest and shy, I ain't never been around much, you know.
Yeah, you're shy. Yeah.
And I'm 30 years shy when I'm telling my age.
How old are you? You weren't expecting that, were you? Well, it says 298. Is that your age?
Yeah.
Oh, that's the price. Okay.
Yeah. Now, that's the price of my hat, Mikey. But anyway, my fella, you know, he really worries about me coming over here. He worries that one of those good-looking guys might run away with me.
Why not?
I wish he would. I mean that when I say that. But you know, the other day he came over to the house the other night, and it was late. It was 8:30. And we were sitting there in the settee. It was so romantic. One by one and each by side. And I have one of those old wall clocks. And that old thing was ticking so slow. It was like, take your time, take your time. I'm gonna get one of those fast ticking clocks that says, get together, get together, get together. I bet you, Mikey, that you don't have one of those slow ticking clocks.
Oh, I don't know, dear. I think mine's a digital and the battery's gone, but I know yours is fast ticking.
You know, it's not safe for a single girl to be alone anymore. The other night, I was out in Grinder Switch. I went for a walk. And this guy came along and said, give me your money. And I said, I ain't got no money. So he frisked me all down. And he said, no, you don't have any money. I said, you do that again and I'll write you a check. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you.
You can all write a check for her now. There's still the finance table.
You know, the other day I ran into Bertha and she told me that the doctor put her pacemaker in wrong. Every time her husband kisses her, the garage door opens. But they ain't never had to replace that door for 20 years. I went to a party the other night, and they had the women standing in the center. And they either kissed you or they paid you. I made $11.48. And one guy said, I'll pay you when I get my money on Saturday. What do you think of that, Mikey?
I think that's good.
Well, I
think... Bad?
You know, they say kissing, you'd probably know. They say kissing causes germs. I've lived a lot of germ-free nights.
Yeah, me too. Been married a long time. I used to be right germy.
I met this lady at this wedding I went to a while ago, and I met her the other day, and I asked her, how are things going? And she said, well, you know, marriage is like jumping into a tub of hot water.
Uh-oh.
After you're in there for a while, it ain't so hot. Thank you.
All right.
Now, Bill up the street, he takes his wife with him everywhere he goes. So I said, Bill, why do you take your wife with you? And he said, well, she's so ugly, it's easier to take her than kiss her goodbye. Thank you. So, thank you.
You know, Minnie, do you know the grinder switch, Dartmouth?
Yes.
Did you see a story a couple of weeks ago that Dartmouth was chosen as one of the sexiest communities in Canada? Did y'all see that in the paper? That's an actual fact of life.
It is. I know that. But I don't know why I can't get any kissing. Anyway, Mikey.
Yes, dear.
I know you can't sing.
I can't.
And my voice is gone.
I think it's good.
The doctor looked at my throat the other day and he said, it looks like you washed your neck and forgot to iron it. But we're going to try and sing with the help of Stevie over here. Bear with us. Stevie,
we've got just the perfect song for you two to sing. We might have to get everybody's help as well. Are y'all ready?
We're ready.
You're ready.
I know this is going to stun some of you, but we didn't rehearse that a whole heck of a lot. Now, I got to just pause here. I want to tell you, this is true. You know, I'm a politician, so I tell you the truth. This is absolutely The truth, this morning I got out of an interview. I was actually doing a thing on a radio station at Seaside 105.9 FM, and I got out to my car and I called my assistant and I said, Kelly, did I get a script for tonight? I don't think so. She said, yep, it came in on Monday, and you expected to know it. So I said, okay, I better get going. So I the phone turned off in the car. I'm driving along, and I turn on one of my favorite radio stations. I love all the local ones, but I happen to kind of like 80s on 8. Have any of you ever listened to 80s on 8 on the satellite stuff? I was born in the 80s, and that really turns me on a little bit. Now, when I turned the radio on, I swear to God, may God strike me dead. This is a Kevlar hat. May God strike me dead if I'm lying. What song do you think I heard from the 80s? The year was 1982, and it was sung by Laura Branigan. And the song was Gloria. That's what I heard. Now, I just want to read you a couple of lyrics and tell me if this reminds you of anybody. Gloria, you're always on the run now. Running after somebody, you're going to get him somehow. I think you gotta slow down before you start to blow it. I think you're headed for a breakdown. Be careful not to show it. Here's my favorite line on Gloria. Gloria, how's it gonna go down? Will you meet him on the main line or will you catch him on the rebound? Will you marry for the money? Take a lover for the afternoon. Feel your innocence slipping away. Don't believe it's coming back soon. That was written for Gloria McCluskey back in 1982, folks. All right, Grindr Switch has just grown in popularity. Let's hear it again for Gloria McCluskey. Gloria will soon be old enough to collect a pension, and here she is on the stage at DSOM 2017. So get your devices out. Beyond rehearsing and glue gunning the flowers to her hat, did you like her hat? Did you happen to like her hat? Gloria's been very busy fundraising. Her agent, Kim Conrad. Is Kim in the house? Where's Kimmy? Kim Conrad over here, ladies and gentlemen. He's a good-looking man over here. Kim has been tireless in his efforts to hit Gloria's targets. Now, there's still time for you to help. Go see Kimmy, one of our volunteers, or drop by the finance table to add to Minnie's tally. And a special thank you tonight to Gloria's gold supporters. Let's get Minnie's price tag growing. Way to go, Minnie. And now it's time to add more music to our Nashville lineup. The Country Divas are getting ready to take to the stage. They're gonna get your spurs a-spinning. Shania Twain, Terri Clark, Faith Hill, they got nothing on these three. By day, Crystal Wentzell is a library support specialist at Ashley Jefferson Elementary School. Lindsay Peach is the VP of Integrated Health Services with the Nova Scotia Health Authority. And Sherry Donovan is the CEO of the Nova Scotia Home Builders Association. All accomplished women, but tonight, they're channeling Shania, Terri, and Faith. Now, ladies and gentlemen, 3 months ago, these ladies had never even met. But tonight, there are three dedicated divas making a difference.
When you look at why you're here, what you're doing, what you're doing. For me, it's very personal from a family perspective. My dad was an RCMP officer, and he has been diagnosed with PTSD. And my daughter, who is 21 and about to have a baby of her own, was diagnosed when she was 13 with a mental health illness.
It is very personal to me. I have had anxiety since I was a small child. To do a benefit like this and to raise money, to maybe get the word out there, to have more support for other people out there. It's a wonderful thing.
My role is Vice President with responsibility for mental health and addictions with the Nova Scotia Health Authority, and also as board member with Mental Health Foundation Nova Scotia. We're not just building a mental health and addiction system, we're also influencing the care that others provide to individuals with mental illness and addictions.
Knowledge is power, because as soon as I understood what was happening, I took control. And by doing that, I was able to reach out and help others as well.
I look at this as a way to help to bring awareness to mental health and to also start getting people to talk about it differently.
What attracted me is this notion of being able to be part of a group to, you know, demonstrate what three strong women can do and how we can participate. So, yeah.
this is definitely well out of my comfort zone, and it's been very rewarding and good for me as far as growth goes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Country Divas featuring Shania Twain, Terri Clark, and Faith Hill.
Don't tell me the reason that you're calling is to see if I'm all right since you've been gone. 'Cause I know you and I know why we're talking. You wanted me to say I'm barely hanging on. Maybe that was true.
She's on a roll and it's all uphill.
Wow! Wow! That's what I call some good old Nashville entertainment. Let's show our thanks again, once again, to the Country Divas, Crystal, Lindsay, and Sherry, as Shania, Terri, and Faith. Now, if these boots fit anybody in the room, and you will admit to having them under the wrong bed, you win $1,000. So come up and try them at the intermission. And the Divas aren't done yet. They need to keep adding money to their pot. Now, DSOM alumni, Danny Shedra. Is Danny here? Where's Danny? Where's Danny? Is he in the room? Danny, over there! Danny's going to sing next year. That's going to be very, very cool. He doesn't know that yet. Danny Shedra is their agent, and we know that he's anxious to get more dollars developing. Westwood Group is a proud gold supporter of the Divas, and Danny's looking for more. So please see him or one of our volunteers to donate to the Divas. So, did you like it? Yeah. It's time for us to wrap up the first portion of the DSOM, but we have two more fabulous acts waiting in the wings. I gotta tell you, unbelievable. The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour. So is the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour in the room tonight? I wanna hear if the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour is in the room tonight. Come on! How about Dolly Parton? Where's Dolly Parton? They gotta be in the room tonight. Come on, yeah! They're still to come. We're gonna take a short intermission, so we encourage you to grab another drink. Drink responsibly, but often. Talk to your friends, support your favorite star, and don't forget to get your wine and dine raffle tickets. Now, is it my understanding that country music fan Peter Millett is making the rounds? Is Peter in the room tonight? Where's Peter? Peter, over there! Peter Millett. Thank you, sir, for your help here tonight. He's making the rounds, so when Peter comes calling, be generous. Before we break, let's take a quick look at the current standings of our stars. All right, folks. There's the numbers. We still got to make those numbers climb a little bit. I see a lot of deep pockets in the room here tonight. So Minnie Pearl at almost 50, the Country Divas at almost 28, Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour over 100,000, and Dolly Parton at almost $30,000. So let's grow those totals, folks. We're gonna see you back here in 15 minutes. As Sherriff, I get people stationed at the doors, there's no leaving. If you leave, you're gonna kick your ass tomorrow morning when you see what you've missed. So Debbie Arnold and her line dancers are ready to do some more dozy doing. Stevie, take us to intermission, buddy. Thank you all very much. Have some fun. Stay where you are. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Gentlemen, welcome back, our own Roy Acuff, Mayor Mike Savage.
Howdy, folks. Take your seats. All right, folks. Put your asses in your seats. Over here, Rob Richardson, sit down. Sit down, sit down. Kevin Cameron, sit down. Who else isn't sitting? All right, folks. It's time to jump back in the saddle and get this night in Nashville fired up again. Come on now, this is no place for hugs. No place for hugs. So I hope some of you had a chance to get your wine and dine raffle tickets to support your favorite stars. Okay. Sit, 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 sit. We got some big time talent waiting here. Now listen, at the break I had a chance to walk around and I saw some of the alumni. How many of you have been to this event before? Let me see a show of hands if you've been here before. So, now I see some of you. Dennis Campbell, I want to thank you for the apple juice before the show. Thank you very much. I saw some great alumni. I saw Dr. Dan. Remember Greece? How many of you saw Greece a couple of years ago? That was great. Where's Dr. Dan? He's over here somewhere. I got to tell you, one of the great performances of all time was Kirby Putnam, who was James Taylor. Do any of you guys remember that from, I don't know if it was last year or 2 years ago? Kirby's with us tonight. I know Danny Shedra sang before. Getting a bit thirsty. Water's good, but if Rob Steele wants to buy me a beer, I'm over here at this table. I want you to remember that the funds that we raise tonight will help ensure Nova Scotians with mental illness and addictions are thriving in our communities. That's why we're here. So let's have a look at where do we stand after the break. Let's go to the scoreboard over here. Oh, there's been a bit of movement, folks. There's been a bit of movement. Minnie Pearl was just shy of $50,000. She's gained $5,000. Kim Conrad's her agent. Minnie Pearl, $54,250. The Country Divas at $36,400. The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour, look at that. They've jumped to $108,000, almost $109,000. And Dolly Parton at $37,166. So, you add that to the money that Team Pat bought in. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause for all the folks who've been supporting this event. So we're looking good. But I got a feeling we could do more. And speaking of giving more, we wanted to take a moment to thank our different Stage of Mind partners. As you know, an event like this requires a lot of support and cowhands. So thanks again to our presenting sponsor, BMO Bank of Montreal. Another round of applause for BMO Bank of Montreal. Thank you for your kindness and your support, Mark, Linda, Rody, and team. As well, thank you to our media sponsor, CTV Atlantic, and our video sponsor, RPM, our branding sponsor, Revolve, and our AV sponsor, FMAV. We simply couldn't do this without your kindness, your expertise, and your generosity. Thank you all very much. We also want to pass along gratitude to our friends at Zed Events. Zed has been bringing this show together for 14 years from the beginning. So pleased to have their team as our event sponsor. So Robert Zed and Zed Events right here, ladies and gentlemen. I don't think this event would happen without Robert and his team. Thank you, sir. All right, it's time to tee up our next talented trio of stars. The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour is ready to rope you in. I want you to watch. Glen Campbell, Willie Nelson, and Patsy Cline, Dalhousie University. Dalhousie University is ready to duel. By day, Richard Florizone is the president of Dal. Peter Fardy is the Vice President of Advancement. And Catherine Bagnell Stiles is the Assistant VP of Communications and Marketing. But tonight, they're trading in their campus for the DSOM stage. Ladies and gentlemen, the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour was a popular music and comedy variety show back in the early 1970s. But tonight, it's all the rage, all over again. Have a look.
this is an illness just like anything else. You cut your finger, you put a Band-Aid on it. You break your arm, you go get it set with a cast. Why is mental illness thought of any differently just because it's not as visible as other ailments?
What I see from where I stand is a lot of positive progress. I see that this generation, there is much less stigma attached, which is great. Students are more open about challenges they're facing.
I hope that we continue to get more comfortable with the conversation, to feel comfortable to share our stories, to not be worried about stigma or judgment.
If you think back 20 years, how much have things changed? Well, think ahead 20 years. How much can things change?
And it's important to create a climate and environment where people feel more comfortable to come forward and seek support and seek assistance and seek help when they need it to remove that stigma.
Sometimes we make the best advances when we go in the direction of things that are uncomfortable, whether they're uncomfortable experiences or uncomfortable conversations. And so that's what this is all about. It is about advancing the conversation.
Mental health is an important topic, right? If we haven't been touched by it directly, we know in our extended families or friends, we all know, if we're honest, people who have been affected by this. That's why we're so pleased to be part of the work of the Mental Health Foundation.
I'm Glen Campbell. Well, we sure are pleased to be with you here tonight, and we really appreciate your support for mental health in Nova Scotia. You might have noticed my shirt has a few rhinestones on it. I got a song about that, and I hope you'll sing along. Take it away, Steve.
Walking these streets so long, singing the same old song. Oh, every crack in these dirty sidewalks are worn. The hustle's the name of the game, and nice guys get washed away like the snow and the rain. There'll be a load of compromising on the road to my horizon, but I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a rhinestone cowboy riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo. Like a rhinestone cowboy getting cards and letters from
Halifax, welcome. Please give it up for my good friend, Miss Patsy Cline. to the stage. Members of my Dalhousie Senior Administrative Team, the Dal Choir. What a fine choir up here. I'm so lucky to be joined by such great colleagues. I see back there my good friend. Wait, I see someone familiar. It's my good friend, Mr. Willie Nelson. Willie, come on up here and sing us a song.
Can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. I'm going places that I've never been. I'm seeing things that I may never see again, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
Mr. Willie Nelson! Please join me in thanking our good friend, Miss Patsy Klein, the Dal Choir, our wonderful band, musical director, Mr. Steve Dukes. And most of all, thanks to you for supporting mental health in Nova Scotia. It's such a pleasure for us to be here with you tonight. But now it's time for us to get on the road again.
On the road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends. On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again.
One more time, we'll agree on home.
I can't wait to get on the road again.
The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour. I want to tell you, Richard, Peter, and Catherine, if you ever decide to get a real meaningful job, you could be musicians. Get out of the academy. Now, what about Willie Nelson? Did that look like Willie Nelson? Yeah? Did that make you feel like sparking one up a little bit? There was a funny scent back in the room back there, and I know what it was now. That's unbelievable. That is Glen Campbell, that is Patsy Cline, that is Willie Nelson. If you'd like to keep the good times going, please let one of our volunteers know or stop by our finance table to add to Dal's already impressive fundraising tally, folks. Peter Fardy has been acting as Willie Nelson. He's also been the group's agent. Great work on both fronts, Peter. And thanks to Glen Campbell's gold supporter this evening, the J&W Murphy Foundation. Thank you very much. Okay. Stevie, we're getting close now.
We're getting close.
We got some good acts this year, huh?
We got great acts this year.
I got to tell you, this guy is one of the most versatile musicians you will find anywhere. Stevie Dukes is so much fun, and what a great group he's got with him tonight.
And one of the greatest bands ever to come together.
Yeah. All right, Stevie, we're going to head into our last act of the evening. After almost 20 years of leading our province's largest union, the NSGEU. Is there anybody here from the NSGEU? Is there anybody here from the NSGEU in the house tonight? We're delighted to have Joan Jessome gracing the stage here tonight. During her time as president of NSGEU, Joan advocated for better mental health consistently and for better health, mental health supports in the workplace and against bullying. At her recent retirement dinner, Joan committed to continuing on with this mission. Tonight, she's transforming herself into the most honored female country performer of all time, Ms. Dolly Parton. She's going to be joined on stage by her sister, Barbara Trudeau, and her sister-in-law, Corinne Weir. Barbara is stepping out of her comfort zone to honor her daughter, Jillian, who lives with autism. While Corinne from Heppy's Pies, anybody heard of Heppy's Pies? Is taken to the stage in support of mental health in her community. Ladies and gentlemen, from Dollywood to DSOM, we're putting Parton and Pals in the spotlight. Let's go.
Mental health doesn't discriminate. There is nobody at any level of income or abilities that cannot be impacted by mental health. The cause is just so important. And there, you know, I've just watched, talked to too many people that have buried their children and their partners and their siblings. And you know, you've got our seniors that are suffering, and you hear these stories over and over again, you realize that if there's an opportunity to do something, then you need to take it. And the reason that I've stepped out of my comfort zone to perform on stage to raise money for the Nova Scotia Mental Health Foundation is because over my 20 years or 20 plus years that I've been involved in the labor movement, I have, without exception, every day have spoken to somebody that is struggling with a mental illness. When you suffer in the workplace and you have nobody that understands the signs and no support, then you start missing time. And then when you start missing time, your job security is at risk. There's a direct correlation between having a healthy workplace and being able to have a healthy home. And so, you know, education, is all, that's what it's all about. The Mental Health Foundation certainly has a very wide arrangement of information that's good for anybody, whether you're in the workplace or not, whether you're a senior, whether you're a student. It's accessible. It's important that people understand that they have to talk about it, and there's no shame in it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dolly Parton and friends.
Hi, you all doing? Well, I want to welcome you all here tonight, and we are the last act of the evening, but this doesn't mean that the struggle is not over. So we stand here tonight because we believe in mental health. We believe that we can do a lot to make it better. And I'm going to be joined on the stage very shortly by some friends of mine, but before I do that, I want to give you a disclaimer. Now, Dolly has a cold tonight because I have a lot of fluid on my chest. So if you think that I'm a little off key, don't be alarmed, because we're going to nail it tonight. And so we're going to start it off because we got a few songs for you, and we want to make sure that you know where your wallets are by the end of the night. So before I move, I'm not going to start singing by myself. Don't be alarmed. But I want to join, I want to come out. I have a good friend tonight that I want to join me on the stage. So now you know that I'm Dolly, right? You know, you can tell, right? It's the blonde hair, right? Just the blonde hair. But I'm going to be joined on the stage tonight by my good friend, Loretta Lynn. Come on out, Loretta.
Hello, Dolly, everybody. What a great night. We've been watching from up in the green room.
Oh, yeah.
And you are lucky folks tonight, and it's only going to get better. But did you know, Dolly, that we have another friend with us tonight?
I was hoping.
Very good friend of ours. Talented, beautiful. She's used to singing with her mama, but tonight she's coming out with us. Ladies and gentlemen, Wynonna Judd.
Come on out, Wynonna.
Hello, gals. This should be fun.
Are you ladies ready to sing?
Let's go.
All right. Let's have it.
Sleep.
for I felt I was rich in my coat of many colors. With every stitch, she told me of the story. Mama told me why she sewed, why my coat of many colors was worth more than all her clothes.
With no shoes upon my feet, and share with you the last bite of bread I had to eat. I would swim out to save you in your sea of broken dreams. All your hopes are sinking. Let me show you what love means.
Love can.
Every heart would understand that love and only love can join the tribes of man. I would give my heart's desire so that you might see the first step is to realize that it all begins with you.
Between your heart and
didn't he say? How, no, what do you say when you're finished?
Howdy!
Howdy! And then when you're finished, when you, what do you say when you finish your jokes and stuff? Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh, my folks. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together again for the 2017 Stars from a Different Stage of Mind. It just wouldn't be a true night in Nashville without a grand old closing number. I dare say we're all united in gratitude for your time and talents. And thank you, Dolly and friends. Joan Jessome was never a bust at the bargaining table.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. If you'd like to add your support to Team Dolly, there's still time. Ray Larkin and Rick Clark have been acting as Dolly's agents. Are they here? Is Rick Clark here and Ray Larkin? I don't know if they're here. They've done a great job, and thank you to Ray Larkin for coming on board as Dolly's gold supporter as well. Thank you to Ray Larkin. So now, ladies and gentlemen, there is an undisputed star in the Mental Health Association of Nova Scotia. And I'd like you to welcome her to the stage now, Star Dobson.
Thank you, Sheriff Mike. On behalf of everyone at the Mental Health Foundation of Nova Scotia, I would just like to pass along our grand old gratitude. This has been an amazing night, and it's because all of you are here and you're all committed to changing the way people think. To the sheriff, who, by the way, postponed or canceled a trip to England to be here with us. You are the best. Thank you so much. You bring so much to the show. Thank you, thank you, thank you. To BMO Bank of Montreal, thank you once again for being our presenting sponsor. And thank you to all of our partners for believing in the work that we do. Speaking of the work we do, I'd like to say a special thank you to our foundation team. We're small, but we're mighty. Kate, Allison, Jennifer, Deb, Sarah, Kara, and Maureen. That's it. They're the women who put this together. Hats off to you ladies.
Thank you, thank you.
To Zed Events, thank you so much. It's wonderful to work with such an amazing team of professionals. And our musical director, Stevie Dukes. But, you know, we wouldn't even have a show if it wasn't for our amazing stars and their agents and all of our volunteers who are here tonight. I'd like to send out a particular thank you to Don and Adam. It means the world to us that you agreed to share Pat's birthday with all of us. And we're so incredibly fortunate to call you friends of the foundation. Thank you so much. This was a fantastic year for DSOM, but we know next year is going to be great as well because it's our 15th anniversary. And you've heard the word alumni tossed around a few times tonight. That's because next year we are thrilled to be bringing back some of our fan favorites from DSOMs through the years. So make sure you're here for the 15th alumni edition of DSOM. But for tonight, thank you once again for being a part of a movement that is so much bigger than any of us. Your talent, your professionalism, and again, your sense of humor are top notch. It takes a lot of courage to do what you did. So thank you very much. Enjoy your night in Nashville, and we'll see you back here next year, y'all.
Do we like Star Dobson here in this province? Do we like Star? All right. This has been a great evening full of entertainment and inspiration, and we're going to draw our Wine and Dine raffle winner's name in just a moment. But first of all, Star,
yes.
We got some hardware to pass out. So let's take a look now at our final tallies for our stars, and these numbers are all super impressive. Ladies and gentlemen, let's roll the numbers. Look over here. Minnie Pearl. $54,500. What do we got? The Country Divas at $46,650. the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour, 109,000 dollars. And Team Dolly, 37,760. Every single one of those numbers is impressive. And that means that we have a winner of our top fundraiser award. Congratulations to the Glen Campbell. Wait a second, I'm supposed to say the wrong one first, aren't I? Isn't that how it goes? Don't they always do the wrong one? Okay. The Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour! I gotta say, for all of you, and especially for the Glen Campbell team, but everybody, your dedication and hard work will absolutely make a difference in the lives of Nova Scotians who are living with mental illness and addictions and their families. And now, this is one of the most important awards in the world. The coveted People's Choice Award. Now, this goes to the most outstanding performance of the evening as determined by your applause. So if you have a favorite act, have another drink first. Take another little sip of wine or something. I want you to make sure you make some noise. We have got a very sophisticated noise, what do they call those things?
Noise meter.
We've got a very sophisticated noise meter that we got. The Russians passed it on to us through Donald Trump. It's a very high-tech piece of work over here. So we're going to be measuring the noise. So I want to ask Don and Adam. Where's Don and Adam? Come on up here, guys. From Team Pat, to give me a hand by presenting this award tonight. Now, are we ready to make some noise for the teams? Okay. All right. Let's hear it for Minnie Pearl.
Make some noise. Make some noise.
All right. Minnie Pearl. You can't beat the young talent out of Dartmouth. Let's hear it for the Country Divas. Stand forward, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Glen Campbell Goodtime Hour. That's good.
Yeah, it's good.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Dolly Parton. Okay, hang on now. Okay, that's good. We also have another team here. So let's hear it for this team, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Team Pat.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I really appreciate your support for all these teams. It's unbelievable. Star, the winner of tonight's People's Choice Award is Team Pat.
It's just like live TV, you never know what's going to happen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good job. You want to say anything?
Yeah, no, thank you for everyone's support here tonight. Like, these numbers are absolutely incredible. I think this is a great foundation that we're all working really hard for. Just to see all these amazing faces is amazing. And obviously, thank you to our closest support group, Team Pat, but, you know, this is great. Let's do this again.
And to take the words from Pat, love more.
All right, folks. I personally think Adam is number two in his genes, but number one in your heart, so we're going to give him that one tonight. Don't be looking at me. Congratulations again to all of our stars. It was a sensational night here in Nashville. It's not quite over, but it's close. Let's give them another round of an applause. Everybody, big round of applause as they leave the stage to take their places over there. You're all invited to get hugs and photos, okay? Hugs and photos at our post-event reception on your way out of Nashville. So hugs and photos, you know, please be polite and reasonable and keep your hands to yourself, but hugs and photos over there. But first of all, our Wine and Dine raffle draw star. Oh, sorry. Was that Joni? Who was that now said that? Yes. Uh-oh. All the fun gone. All right. We're going to do the Wine and Dine raffle draw. The prize includes dinner for eight in your own home prepared by a chef from the Berkeley with wine pairings from Bishop's valued at over $1,000. All right. Come on over here. You announce it. The winner is...
Kim Smith Kraus.
What was it? Kim Smith Kraus. All right. Thank you. Thanks again to all of you, to our presenting sponsor, BMO Bank of Montreal, CTV Atlantic, Revolve, RPM, Z Events, FMAV. The team here did a great job at the World Trade and Convention Center. I got to thank Jen, who's been spending time backstage doing a great job of sort of wrangling all of the talent. The Trade and Convention Center, Atlantic Digital Reproductions. We'd also like to give a big shout out to Scott Munn from Photo Munn. Thank you very much to Scott. To our volunteer hairstylists. Look at these heads over here. They worked hard. The volunteer hairstylists from Thumper's Salon. To our volunteer makeup artists from Salon Resource Group and our decor provider, Glow, the event store. Now, if you happen to think you have what it takes to be a performer, let us know. As Star said, A Different Stage of Mind will mark its 15th year next year, so we're going to have some alumni. I personally think it would be great to see Star Dobson and Robert Zed do a kind of a thing together to commemorate 50. Do you think that would be good? She said she'd do it if there's a big round of applause. I'm thinking Sonny and Cher or something. We'll work it out. 15 years next year, and think about all the work and all the lives who've been impacted positively. I started the night as the sheriff, and I'd like to wrap it up by giving you all a summons to join us again, this time next year, for the 15th anniversary of A Different Stage of Mind. And in the meantime, I charge you all with continuing to help us change the way people think about mental health and addictions. It's a fun night, it's a serious issue, we're making progress, but there's work to be done. And on behalf of STAR, the Mental Health Foundation of Nova Scotia, thank you all, thank you, thank you, thank you, good night. And I want the best band in the land, Little Stevie and the Swingin' Buckaroos. Play us out of here, Stevie. Right. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.